Hi, hello, welcome to Spell Day. We're covering a spell every single day of the year from the 5e PHP plus 3. Those plus 3 spells are homebrew spells. We're at plus 2 at the moment. You can head back and play this to find them. And today's spell is Reverse Gravity. 7th level transmutation, cast time of 1 action, range of 100 feet, components verbal somatic material, a lodestone, and iron filings. Duration, concentration, up to 1 minute. The spell reverses gravity in a 50-foot radius, 100-foot high cylinder centered on point within range. All creatures and objects that aren't somehow anchored to the ground in the area fall upward and reach the top of the area when you cast this spell. Creature can make a dexterity saving throw to grab onto a fixed object if it can reach, thus avoiding the fall. If some solid object, such as a ceiling, is encountered in this fall, falling objects and creatures strike it just as they would during a normal downward fall. If an object or creature reaches the top of the area without striking anything, it remains there, oscillating slightly for the duration. At the end of the duration, affected objects and creatures fall back down. Not many things are built to be pulled. What I mean by that is a question. So most construction, buildings-wise, are built so they hold things up. They're not built to hold things down most of the time. So, let's say you just reverse gravity. Theoretically, a lot of rooftops, especially with the type of architecture, at least the tiles on top of it, would go up. The amount of cobblestone roads that go up into the air, any object, carts, buckets, the amount of clutter that would actually go up in a 50-foot radius, 100-foot tall cylinder is immense. Because also, does it affect the ground around it? What's the barrier where it just stops enacting it? Is it a perfect cylinder, meaning that if you do it on some lower terrain and like a hill clips into the side of it, is that dirt suddenly going to begin going up? Because like, let's say, an example from one of the campaigns I ran, there's an ambush in the desert, as in the players are ambushing these enemies. They cast reverse gravity in the center of them, in the in-between bit of two different dunes. Is all the sand going up as well? Because that's the way I ran it. But even at that point, it's all oscillating. It's not going to be another stable ground upside down. Though, like, if you're in the Underdark or in a heavy cave system, likely it would still hold. But when it comes to basic buildings, you might just go straight through a thatched roof. But no, this is battlefield and player spell amazing, because it's the incapacitation of levitate on everything. Because let's say if you do this in open air, it's just going to be stuck there in the air, unless it somehow, because that's the thing, if you have nothing to grab onto, how are you moving? If you don't have any fly or anything? Because at that point, even if you could move, you still have a 100-foot fall. You already fell up, which you might not have hit anything, but if you go off, you have a 100-foot fall. That's 10d6. And this is a spell that has an effect tied to a situational saving throw. A dexterity save if there is something anchored you can grab onto nearby. If you have nothing, like if you're on an entirely smooth stone floor, there's nothing to grab onto, you're screwed. You've gone up. If all that's there is grass, good luck. If you're in plate armor and all that gravity's been flipped, there's no way that's holding you. There's no way grass is holding you regularly either. Vertically? Or not vertically, but upside down? Concentration's spell slot are definitely worth it for this effect, just because in the campaigns I've seen it used just instantly. I mean, yeah, if it's going against a flying creature, it's not going to do much. If it's going against ground troops or any forces like that, or one melee fighter, send them into the air. Now just shoot him to death. Same thing with levitate previously. Check that out. I mean, it has so many of the same benefits of levitate, but instead of having a con save tied to it, it's a potential dex save, and it's a massive area. Not to mention, this affects objects as well, which, again, if you want to do this for city or building scenarios, I mean, a lot of them are to hold their roof up. They're not to keep it down. Defenses, trench lines, you can just cast this, send them up. I guess a fun use, you could use this for elevators. Because you oscillate at the top, so if you make a shaft that's about 110 feet tall, and you have a permanent one of these at the bottom, or a glyph of warding, or you cast this at the bottom, or whatever the situation is, or an item, you head there, it activates, and you get pushed up to the top, and you kind of hover there for a bit, and you can just step onto a ledge. Like the giant mushroom from Dragonborn DLC. Anywho, outside of that, it's amazing. Let's go. 8 out of a 10. It's a CC that just says, Battlefield's different now. Everything is upside down. Oh god, another moment from a campaign was they were in a cave and there were a bunch of stalactites on the ceiling. Flipped it up, a bunch of goblins just got hurtled into it. 100-foot drop, and it's goblins. They're not surviving. It's bad. Because that's the other thing is, if you do have a ceiling like that and it's roughly at that max distance, cast it, send them up, get a little few rounds of damage in, and then if you don't care anymore, drop it. They're going to fall again. Not to mention, if you want to burn spell slots, like if a target has feather fall so they can protect themselves from the initial release, they touch the ceiling or whatever they're on, stop casting this again. Now they either cast feather fall again, or if they didn't have a proper reaction at that time, they just fall. But no, it's good. But I think it's still balanced at this level, roughly. That's why it's not 10 out of 10. If it was a lower level, that'd be 10 out of 10. But no, 9 out of 10. It's fantastic.